Good morning all of you. Now we are going into the topic signal analysis. The first part we have completed it. The second part we are yet to start. In the second part, what is done is an orthogonal vector space is taken and an orthogonal signal space is taken, and we try to compare both the things and we see what are the similarities between them, so that we are trying to develop the analogy between vectors and signals. Okay. Now, suppose say you take a vector A which has the coordinates x1, y1, z1, then its components along x, y, z axis are x1, y1 and z1. That's why it is x1, y1, z1, A vector. Now, orthogonal vector space. Now, if we take Vx or Vy or Vz to be the unit length vector along xyz direction, then we know that Vx dot Vx is equal to Vy dot Vy is equal to Vz dot Vz equal to 1. Similarly, Vx dot Vy or Vy dot Vz or Vz dot Vx equal to 0. Okay. If it can also be said as VA dot VB equal to 1 if A equal to B, VA dot VB equal to 0 if A is not equal to B. Okay. Now, a vector A can be expressed in the terms of its component vectors as A is equal to x1 Vx plus y1 Vy plus z1 Vz. Okay. Now, if we take the concept of three dimension, that is the equation. Now, if you are taking n-dimensional space, which does not exist practically, but theoretically it will exist, A is equal to x1 Vx plus y1 Vy plus z1 Vz plus n1 Vn. Okay. The component of A, the component of vector A along x-axis, how to get, if you multiply A with Vx, then you will get A with Vx dot Vx will be equal to 1, and this all goes to 0, and x1 will be equal to A dot Vx. Okay. Then along Vy, it is A dot Vy. Along Vz, it is A dot Vz. Okay. Similarly, for n dimensional space, the component of A along some g axis will be a dot vg. Now if you see, this is typo error, is not c, it is a, it is ag, avg. Avg is equal to x1 vx plus y1 vy plus z1 vz plus g1 vg plus n1 vn into vg. Now if you are opening this braces, what happens? X1 vx dot vg, Vy dot Vg, Vz dot Vg, Vg dot Vg, Vn dot Vg. All this goes to 0 except this Vg dot Vg, which goes to 1, and you will get G1. So G1 is nothing but Avg is equal to G1, Vg dot Vg equal to 1, or G1 into Vk, G1 into K. Okay. So that is what you get. Now if you take this G1, G1 is equal to Avg by K, Avg by K. A is the vector, Vg is the component, is the direction in which we are finding the component G1. K is nothing but Vg dot Vg. Now, orthogonal vector space is completed. Now you see orthogonal signal space means you don't have vectors now, you have signals. If you take signals, xj dot xk into dt equal to 0 when j not equal to k, and if it is j equal to k, xk square kk. Okay. Now f of t will be equal to c1 x1 of t plus c2 x2 of t plus cn xn of t plus fe. Is equal to r equal to 1 to n CR XR of T. Okay, now f of error of t is equal to f of t minus sigma c1 r of t. Okay, now if you try to find out the mean square error, it will be minimum under this condition. Under the condition ck will be equal to integral t1 to t2 f of t xk of t dt by integral of t1 to t2 xk of t whole square dt. So this is how you get. So there is a similarity between vectors and signals. So here we try to develop the same. Okay, mean square error. How to calculate mean square error? We know error mean of the square of the error. So epsilon will be equal to 1 by t2 minus t1 t1 to t2 fe of t whole square dt. 1 by t2 minus t1 t1 to t2. Okay, we are trying to calculate mean square error. Epsilon is equal to 1 by t2 minus t1 integral t1 to t2 fe of t whole square. Fe of t is nothing but f of t minus r equal to 1 to n cr xr of t whole square. Now if you calculate and try to put in the equations, mathematical steps, you can go through any textbook, so you find this kind of derivation. If you try to find this, it will be equal to epsilon will be equal to 1 by t2 minus t1 f square of t minus c1 square k1 c2 square k2 c1 square k1. The above equation is used to evaluate the mean square error. Okay, now closed and complete set of orthogonal functions. What is a closed or complete set of orthogonal functions is you are not able to find out any other function which satisfies the orthogonality concept with this set of functions. If at all no such vector is there which is orthogonal to one of the set of functions, orthogonal functions, then the set is called as orthogonal set. Okay, so that is orthogonal set function. Now orthogonality in complex functions. In complex functions, here also f of t is equal to c1 to f2 of t, but how to find c1 to integral of f1 of t into not f2 of t but f conjugate to f2 conjugate of t dt by t1 to t2 f2 of t whole square dt, where f2 conjugate of t is conjugate of f2. Okay, now if they are orthogonal, if f1 of t are orthogonal, then t1 to t2 f1 of t f2 conjugate of t dt is equal to 0, then f1 of t conjugate f2 of t is equal to 0. Thank you all of you. So with this we have completed first unit. We will take up the topics of second unit in the coming classes.